Hello everybody, Dark Skeleton here, and in this video I want to give you guys my top 5 list for the best TCG games that you can get on PC right now in 2017. Every game on this list I have personally played, and it is organized from least favorite to favorite. But remember, every game has to be pretty good to even make this list. So number 5 on this list is Faria, which is a tactical land creation and management based TCG where you have to actually create the land where you play on and you summon creatures too. From the games I have played of it, it's interesting because the actual play style seems to be very close to something you would expect from Magic the Gathering. And maybe that's because in most of the games of Faria, it tends to build up a large board of a lot of big minions, and that's not just because I'm playing green, but even with some of the other colors like red and blue, I kind of get that sense. On top of that, it should be mentioned that the colors inside of Faria are very, very close to what you have in Magic the Gathering. Your colors are red, blue, green, and yellow, which is closest to black in Magic the Gathering. And then you could argue that the neutral color is sort of like white because that's where all the humans are at. But putting all that aside, the land management in combination with TCG mechanics makes it a very in-depth game. It's a good option for methodical players that are going to see those lines where they can increase their win percentage by 1 or 2% in a very non-obvious way. Number 4, Duelist. So this game has some similarities to Faria in that it is a tactical based game. You summon minions around your hero, and your hero himself can attack. On every single turn, you're able to replace one card in your hand, so there's very little excuse for having a dead draw. Surprisingly, although you could play a strategy where you hide behind your minions, I found that in most of the matchups, you have to play more aggressively, so you can have a hero running straight at the other hero in order to deal damage and take damage. There's a lot going on, and also a lot of really unique cards inside of the game, especially if you pick up some of the legendaries. One thing I found a bit lacking about the game was poor rewards on the daily quests. Usually you get about 4/10 of the pack on each daily quest, but in Duelist that tends to be more like 20 or 25. That said, you do get a free card for logging in each day, which is nice. Probably more so than any other TCG I've played, the positioning of your minions inside of Duelist is a huge deal. A good player will try to put their ranged minions as far away from the rest of your guys as possible, which could even mean putting minions on your side of the board, warping them across the map, or playing a very annoying repulsor beast which can take any enemy minion and push it to any tile you want. Number 3 is Gwent. So this game is based on the Witcher franchise, which is a very successful and well-renowned RPG over the last 5 or 6 years. Gwent is a very different type of card game because you cannot actually attack with your minions. When you put a minion onto the board, it actually provides you power towards winning a round, and the first person to win 2 rounds is the winner of the match. So there's no life bar to defeat. The only thing you have to do to win is to make sure you have more power than the other guy on board when the round ends. Now that doesn't mean that you can't interact with the opposing board. There are many effects that reduce the power of enemy minions, boost the power of yours, or reduce enemy power over time. With so many cards in the game, there's an optimal way to play the card to get the most value out of it, and then there's the way you have to play it on average because you just don't have the right combo pieces in hand. So finding out how to milk the most value from your hand ends up being what this game's all about. Number 2, Elder Scrolls Legends. So this is one of the newer TCGs that have come out, and it's easy to look at it and be like, oh, okay, even Elder Scrolls is getting on the TCG bandwagon, how is this going to turn out? But you should put those cynical expectations aside, because Elder Scrolls Legends is actually a really mechanically solid game. In Elder Scrolls Legends, there's about 5 deck types that you can build your deck around, and they're not categorized by color, but rather what playstyle that type of card has. So endurance cards are going to be good for playing for the late game because they're trying to outlast their opponent. But you can also combine up to 2 colors in one deck, which adds so much depth to the game. And you would think, oh, well, the aggressive color wouldn't go good with the endurance color, but actually there are a lot of different card types within those general categories. So there's a lot of interesting crossover decks you can create, like an item-based deck that plays multiple colors. Number 1, Hearthstone. So if you're subscribed to my channel, this should come as no surprise, because my channel has primarily been a Hearthstone channel. But after experimenting with other TCG games in the last few months, I still do feel that Hearthstone has a slight edge over some of the other games. According to some of the highly skilled players, aka Legend players, there's about 18 or so decks in the meta right now that are actually viable, which is more than there's ever been in Hearthstone for the most part. It might look like a really simple game, but there's actually a fair amount of depth to it, but not so much that a casual player would be put off. The game has a very active pro scene, and I think one of the things that makes it so interesting is that many of the big YouTubers in the TCG realm actually are actively playing Hearthstone. So yes, the community does have an impact on making it interesting, keeping things fresh, coming up with new deck ideas. And in just a couple of days now, they're going to be announcing the next set, which of course I'm pretty hyped for. But if you go with any of the 5 TCGs I've talked about on this list, I think you're gonna have a solid time. They're all fun in their own right. But maybe it could be said that they're aimed at slightly different audiences, because some games are a bit more in-depth and hardcore than others. But I've been Dark Skeleton, thanks for watching my top 5 list on TCG games for the PC in 2017, and I'll see you guys in my future video content.